Okay, so I'm just going to invite you to get comfortable, get a comfortable stance. You can bring your feet together. Feel alignment of the earth, your body, and the sky. And we're going to do a mindful adjustment of our posture. We're going to sink our knees, tuck our tailbone a little bit, stretch out our spine. Feel that your head is sort of like floating, like it's floating like a ball in a pool. Shoulders drop and hands are soft. Put your finger in your navel. Breathe now into your navel, gently. The navel was once our mouth, initially. Until we were born, and then our breathing and our food came through our mouths after we were born. So honoring our tummy button in that way. And it's still a very powerful energetic center. Then bringing one hand slowly up as if you're pouring out anxieties of the future, and then the other hand pouring out the regrets of the past. And where they fuse together is the present moment. The present moment focus is the intent of this practice. Taking a breath in, we float our arms up and step to the side, and then we exhale, coming down. And just feel the ground just now, and the connection with the ground. Just allow your feet to feel natural and start shaking your hands. Breathing naturally into your belly. Bringing your hands up your torso slowly, up to your chest, shoulders, above the head, behind you. And then start pumping your ankles and your knees. Just allow yourself to do that. And listen to the music and start moving with the music. Thank you.
ahead, catch your breath if you need to. And see how you feel.
Embrace all sensation, all feeling. Notice any shifts. Releasing all the energy that you don't need back to the ground. And then bring your hands together and feel the pulse between your hands. Sometimes we have to squeeze a little bit harder, sometimes less. Just when you feel that little pulse in the center of each palm. Notice when you put your hands together, do you notice any tension anywhere in your body? If you do, just acknowledge it and let it go. Is there any reason that you stop breathing when you do that? Anywhere there you stop breathing? And acknowledge it and let it go. Now with one hand, grasp your thumb with the other hand. And embrace all sensation, all feeling. And notice if there's any difficulty breathing when you hold that thumb in your hand. Acknowledge. Let it go and then breathe through that. Breathe into the thumb if there's any resistance there. And gently breathe and let it go. And switching and do the same with your index finger, your pointer finger. Notice any tension in any part of your body. Feel any tension in your back, a particular side of your body. Or any difficulty breathing or blockages breathing. Acknowledge that. Breathe in. Let go. We move over to your middle finger and do the same thing. Hold your middle finger with your other hand. Notice any shifts of feeling. What part of your body do you feel now? Do you feel your stomach, your belly, your solar plexus, or somewhere else? Any tension anywhere, just breathe gently into it. And release and let it go by exhaling out. Now to your ring finger, hold it with the other hand. Notice. Any tension maybe in your hands, maybe in your feet? Breathing into it and gently relaxing and letting it go. And then put your pinky in your hand and notice the same, any tension anywhere. Have you stopped breathing? Breathe in through your pinky or any part of your body that you feel tension, and let it go. Now switch hands and allow the palm to cover your thumb of the other hand. Again, noticing and feeling all sensations, all feelings. Notice any tightness around your body, maybe by your mouth, maybe, or somewhere else. Acknowledge it, breathe into it, and release. Holding your index finger, notice any feeling around your foot, your right foot, your left foot, your shoulders. Any thoughts of a situation where you've had to go in front of a group and talk to a group of people? Tension, inhale, any such memory, and release and let go. And then hold on to the middle finger. Notice any shifts in energy, any feelings. Become aware of your internal world, your internal thoughts. Any tension that's present, breathe into it, acknowledge it, and let it go. Holding your ring finger down when you're ready. Notice any shift in energy. This may have to do with all your connections in life, all the people that are important to you in your life. This includes your social network, the people that are alongside of you along this journey each and every day. Is any tension, just breathe into it. Any part of your body, and let it go. And now holding onto your pinky finger. The pinky finger often represents our business world and our communication skills. Anything comes to mind, acknowledge, breathe into it, and let it go. Now with one hand, grab the wrist of the other hand with your thumb and press down. If you sense any tightness anywhere, whether it's in your breath or any part of your body, acknowledge, breathe in, and let it go. Move up to the middle of your forearm and do the same. Allow yourself to feel all sensation, all feeling, moving up towards your elbow. Breathing in, to your, just above your elbow. Your bicep. Again, acknowledging any tension in any part of your body. Acknowledging your breathing, your breath. Is it natural or is it held up in any way? Breathe into it and let it go. Your upper arm. Just hold your upper arm. What do you feel? Breathe into it. And let it go. Put your hand up on your shoulder. Same thing. Breathe into it. Acknowledge. Let go. And putting your hand on your upper corner of your chest, where your lung points are. Sense any sensation, feeling, awareness. Breathe in and let it go. And then switch hands and go up your wrist of your opposite hand. Embracing all sensation, all feeling, acknowledging any tightness, any difficulty breathing. By breathing into that area and acknowledging and letting go. Let's do that all the way up your arm. There's no hurry. Working your way up your arm, if you do sense some tightening of your breath, ask yourself, is there any reason why it's not safe to breathe? Acknowledge, breathe in. One deep breath in, release that posture and then feel the ground. Move your feet a little bit. And acknowledge all sensation, all feeling. And remember, your hands are the gateway of your heart. So it does the will of the heart. All these meridians run to your hands. And so when we actually reach out to somebody, we are acting through our heart. And we're also, when we reach out, sharing our love with that person. And also, it serves to set limits. So we can also say, these are our limits, by pushing our hands out. So they serve both purposes. But at the end of the day, they're serving our heart. So feeling the ground just now, allow yourself to just breathe and float the arms up. And exhale. Sink the arms down. like a wave as you inhale. It's like a tide going up. And exhale, it's like the tide going down. I invite you to take a deeper stance now. This is known as horse stance. And if you've done some yoga, you probably know of goddess pose. So it's sort of like a goddess pose. And we call this bear pose, okay? So the bear is both strong, powerful, and yet conserves energy. So we do this calling the bear turns. As we exhale, we move to one side, slowly, keeping the torso straight, exhaling or inhaling to center, exhaling to the side. Inhale, center. I'm just doing this at your own pace. Remember, long, smooth, and deep breaths. Gentle movements. Present moment focus. All contribute to that elixir in our bodies of relaxation and health. Now as you go to one side, next time you go to one side, what we're going to do is, from bear pose, we're going to press our hands down. As we exhale, inhale up, turn, slowly, exhale down, inhale up, and just do that at your own pace. Feeling the power, the strength of the bear, yet the efficiency and calmness of movement. The total confidence and comfort wherever that bear is. Wherever that bear is, whoever's in front of the bear always seems confident in itself, unafraid, unbothered. Whether they're picking berries, or they're eating salmon. Or getting the honey from a beehive. There's a certain calm and efficiency in what they do. Just let your hands drop down and feel the earth below you. And then inhale up, bring both hands up, around, and then exhale, bend at your torso all the way down to the ground as if you're a windmill. Inhale up, exhale down. Just connect to your breath, your own body mechanics. Inhaling up and exhaling down. It's sort of like the circle of life. Our lives have many cycles, just like the years. Revolution of the planet, the cycles of the seasons. And then when you want, you can change directions. But the truth is, we have many of these cycles going on at the same time in our lives. We're managing multiple cycles. Whether it's a cycle of school, whether it's a cycle at work, the cycle of friendship and relationship. All these cycles are going on simultaneously. Just like the pulse of a drumbeat, an opening and a closing, all these cycles have those features. And then when you're at the ground, when you cycle down to the ground, just bring up your arms and just shake off any excess energy into the ground and let it store there. Slowly, vertebrae by vertebrae back up. And bring your feet together more in a hip-width-distance stance. Shake it out a little bit. And notice how you feel. So again, we're exploring the heart today, and we're looking at what do we need to do so that our heart can set the rhythm for the rest of the body, because its role with the other organs is to help set a rhythm. And that rhythm is also interpreted by our lungs, our liver, our digestive system, and it's the heart that sets the beat. So one of the things that we can do is, we've done this movement before, and it's one that we create like a rooftop over our heart like this, and then we just say ha as we bring it out, and then we bring it back in, create that rooftop over our heart again, and ha. We can make it more of a whisper quality, or we can make it more physical quality of listen to yourself, what your need is in that voicing. As we push out, we let go of that which we no longer need or serves us. And what we bring back is everything that we need. As you finish, put your hands over your heart. And then we're going to go over the associated organ to the heart, which is the small intestine. So we're going to put our hands over our tummy button, and we're going to rotate 9 times, moving outwardly around our tummy button to encompass our whole stomach. Breathing as we do so, in and as we drop down, exhale. Breathing in as we come up, exhale as we drop down. Then go the opposite direction, making a smaller circle 9 times each time. And then put one of your hands up on your sternum, and one over your heart, and one on your tummy button. As we exhale, you're going to slightly sit, like do what we call wave breathing. Exhale, and then inhale, wave up. Exhale, wave down. Turn to the side. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Yourself to just explore that movement. By breathing this way, we massage the internal organs, stimulating the chi along our spinal cord and all the meridians that run up and down our back. Releasing that movement and feeling the ground again, noticing and feeling all sensations. Now I invite you to take one step forward with one foot. We're going to do pushing away. So inhaling back, with straightening out your front foot, and then exhaling, we're going to push forward, bend that knee, inhale, come back, and straighten the knee, exhale, bend the knee, and lean forward. Tie to your breath with your breath, and find the comfortable stance that's comfortable for you and your movement. Remember, Qigong is all about comfort and getting away from stress. We have enough stress during the day. This is a way of creating relaxation, which counters the stresses in our body. This is from living in the modern world, whether we're on our cell phones, whether we're driving in traffic. Somehow we have this innate ability within us to imagine what it is like to push a wave. Even though we may have never really pushed a wave, we might have pushed in some water, yet we sort of have a feeling of what that might be like. Coming back and switching sides. Exhale, push. And bend the leg, inhale, straighten, and come back. Feel as if you're pushing this wall of water in front of you. That we're connected to the water. We're not just pushing against it, we're pushing with it. We're just one part of the ocean, just a mechanism of the ocean. One with that pure force of water. A river cuts through rock not through its strength, but it cuts through rock with its persistence. And again, they say, water that moves never stagnates. So we're always moving, always staying healthy, keeping the flow of chi within our bodies. And releasing that and seeing how you feel. So we're going to do some healing sounds right now. So with the heart, there's three healing sounds. The first one is to activate the heart. So that's where we carry not only cruelty and hate, but we also carry love and joy. So moving from a state of indifference is also considered part of the heart. We're going to move to a state of sincerity. So from not caring to caring. So the first sound is Xin, X-I-N. So we say Xin, and we do it like a staccato way. Like Xin. Sometimes we hold things in our heart for a long time. And sometimes we hold pain in our heart for a long time. But sometimes to let in joy, we have to release that pain or that hate or that hurt. And we're going to do that now with this movement. And this is more Xian, X-I-A-N, Xian. And sort of prolonged, but we do it sort of breathy-like when we let go. Xian. Xian. Finish up your last one. And notice any shifts in your heart. Did you let anything go? Do you feel some chi having been released in your heart? Do you feel that chi within your field? As it evaporates out of you, notice any shifts in your energy. Shift around with your feet a little bit for a second. And we're going to do the final Shin exercise, the heart sound, but this one's a little bit different when we're doing it. We're going to say much softer, and we're going to put our tongue up to where our teeth and the top of our mouth meet as we say at the end of it. So softly, and this is transforming any of our indifference into sincerity and joy. Basically, moving in out of our heart that energy, that sincerity and joy, and bringing it up to our upper dantian, or our third eye, so that we can realize that transformation of that shift of energy into joy. So imagine that energy as you say, going up to that head space as you put the tongue up to your roof of your mouth, all the way to your top of your forehead and crown. Feel your tongue vibrating like a reed up on your mouth. Feel all sensations and feelings. Feel any shifts in your body, your energy. I know that my energy shifted amazingly up to my third eye. And what really helped with that was the vibration of my tongue up on the roof of my mouth. I can really feel that energetically, the vibration. So this is called the Three Treasures Meditation. Okay, so the three treasures are referring to our body, our mind, and our hearts. Okay, and associated with that are our three dantians. Our upper dantian is our mind, and I would say our heart is our middle dantian, right? And has to do with our core and our how we care about ourselves and care about others. And then our lower dantian is and our breath, right? And our lower dantian is our body. So I'm going to invite you to just reach up, and as if you're making a big beach ball, the hands are like eyes looking up to the sky. And with every inhale in, fill your lungs. But with every exhale, imagine this ball filling up with your breath or with chi. In fact, you can sort of feel it expand as you breathe out, because that chi fills that ball. And we're talking about filling the area of our upper dantian, filling it with chi, filling it with wisdom, filling it with insight, filling it with all the gifts of the heavens, with the boundless opportunities that life has to offer. Filling it with our creativity, filling it with our spirit in connection to the divine. Knowing that any chi that you gather here in your upper dantian, all the intent with that chi, all the thoughts, all the choices we make in life are blessed by the divine. So having that confidence that whatever decisions we make or have made was for our own proper upliftment and our own divine path through life. Exhale, and then release down your hands towards the ground and feel the ground. And then with your palms facing inward, as if you're holding a big ball, breathe into that ball and filling that ball with chi, filling that lower dantian chi. Meanwhile, be mindful of your head as if it's a beach ball floating on top of a pool. You're feeling your back's relaxed but stretched out. With every breath, we breathe in our sense of calm, a sense of centeredness, our sense of connection, that we're like the earth, we're like a rock. We're very stable. We're secure. We're sure-footed and confident in ourselves. That no matter what, a wind can't pull us or knock us over. We are that stable and grounded. And here we can feel the pull of the earth drawing us all the way to the center of the planet. Feeling the earth encase us, feeling the earth holding us. So all the chi that we breathe into this lower downtown area serves like a battery for our whole body. And whatever actions that we take with our body and our beings, whatever actions we take, are blessed by the divine. So no matter what we do in our lives, it's necessary for our own divine unfolding and understanding. Inhale and exhale, slowly bring your hands up to shoulder level as if you're holding a tree. You're hugging a tree or embracing oneness with all of existence. As we breathe into the area between our hands, if we're holding a big ball or holding a tree, we feel the chi expand. And this is the chi of our middle dantian. This is the chi of our own loving, our sharing of ourselves, the connections that we have with ourselves, the connection we have with others that are important to us in our lives. In connection with all of existence, all of life, all the trees, all the birds, all the cats, all the animals and pets, the flowers. We're connected in a web of all of life, interconnected with all of nature, interconnected with other humans, our families. This represents all the sum of our connections. Breathing in chi into this area and feeling that chi. And knowing whatever connections we make, that it comes from a place of loving intent, that connection is blessed by the divine, that all our connections in life are there for our proper unfolding and divine development. For our learning. Inhale and then exhale, put your hands down to the ground. Move your feet a little bit. And see if you notice any shifts. allowing yourself to breathe naturally.
And we're going to finish this.
You're not in a hurry, are you? Aisha, let me see. Did you like doing the drifting? We did the drifting last time with the flute music.
Which one was it?
We put the flute music on, we just allowed ourselves to drift.
I'll put it on. Oh, yes.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Is that something you would like to do?
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe just doing a ball of chi, inhaling and expanding that ball, and exhaling, concentrating the energy. And as you do that, shift your weight to the sound of the flute. Are connected with long, smooth, and deep breaths and gentle movements. And little by little, allow yourself to naturally unfold into other movements that feel good to you, creating chi when we do so. When we feel good, we create a super powerful, relaxed chi that's like a concentrated, natural elixir, a medicine of relaxation. Thank you.
Slowly, I invite you to bring your awareness back to the
room.
Take a deep breath in. Allow yourself to focus on the sound of this bowl.
Inhale in and flap your arms up like a bird to bring your feet together. Bring your hands up to prayer position. Take this moment to smile within yourself. Smile and radiate that loving heart energy throughout your body. It's the pulsing of the heart and the electromagnetic waves of the heart that keep everything in our bodies functioning and timed. So we want to ask our heart, is there anything we can do to ensure that the heart is functioning, is healthy? And we do this by looking after the needs of the heart. The needs of harmony, the needs of safety, the needs of loving connection and protection, of joy. And when we do those things for ourselves, we do that also for the heart. Take this moment and thank your heart for all it does for you every day. The element of the heart is fire. It's that creative element within us. Allowing that fire to burn brightly. Making our smile glow, our skin glow with joy, excitement, and love. Meeting every day's challenges with that level of joy. To share not only with ourselves, but it naturally flows to those around us. Inhaling up, allow this, your prayer hands move like a flame, signifying our fire. And we let it reach up all the way above us. And then inhale again. Bring your hands back down, the back of our hands together in front of us, inhale. And then just offer the very best of ourselves to ourselves and the world around us. And give yourself and the world a blessing for the day. Whatever that quality from the heart that you want to bestow upon yourself and upon the world with loving kindness. Making one hand into a fist, the other into a palm, we bring them together The fist signifying power, the palm love. We always exert our power with love, compassion, and kindness. Thank you so much for sharing this day with me.